We are flightless fairies.
Ever flightless fairies, so I'm like an ostrich or a penguin?
Yes.
As fairy queen, we must have some superpowers, like making strikes, like power eating minds, or running incredibly fast.
Actually, we have the power to tell an enchanted story.
And sometimes cause a little mischief. That's not really as cool as super strength. So are we going to tell one of these stories? These are all great stories. Beauty and the Beast, Rapunzel, Snow White, these are all amazing stories. How about we do Jack and the Beanstalk? I love the Jack and the story. Fee, fi, fo, fum. I smell the blood of some not fun.
Our tale is not in this book, but this book will be in our tale.
Our tale is not in this book, but this book is in our tale. Did you get that line on the fortune cookie? I'm confused.
For the story is about to begin.
About time.
We must do our enchanted bandit to start the story.
Yes, we must.
No enchanted fairy dance and telling the whole story, that sounds like a lot of work. How about we get a narrator and she can tell the story? And we can occasionally interject wits and mischief besides their great food backstage.
What kind of food?
Great crackers, fancy cheese.
Do they have brie cheese?
Yes!
This is a fabulous idea!
We'll get a narrator!
Trees looking divine.
Thank you, darling. And it looks like you are making fine progress on that jigsaw puzzle.
I got another puzzle piece in.
Nice work.
King Barnabas and Queen Mildred move with grace and dignity, and their royal subjects adore them.
I sure hope this therapist helps. The children have simply been unbearable.
I hope
The neurotherapist from SD.
Okay, please send her.
I present to you the royal therapist.
Thank you for coming.
Your Majesties, I'm here to serve you. What is the problem and how may I help?
It's the children. They're just, well, they, I mean, they're so, oh.
I'll just send them. Royal servants, please fetch the children.
Yes, Your Majesty.
I'll get the royal counterpart if necessary.
What is that?
It's the children.
Oh my. I'm hurrying! Get off my case already!
Yeah, don't be so bossy.
Yeah, wasn't the little royal servant? I'm so cool out there.
I was totally going to take a real nap. And now you're making us do stuff.
I present to you the royal children.
Prince Hoshe, where is your crown?
This is on my hair.
Children, this is the new royal therapist.
It's a pleasure to meet you. I look forward to our journey of self-discovery together. Whatever.
Please behave for this nice therapist. Now sit, children.
Yes, Mother. Just like we always do.
That's what I'm afraid of.
What? Oh.
They're all yours. Good luck.
Yes, my brave soul. Good luck.
Thanks, but I'm a trained professional. I don't need good luck. Your Majesty, please control yourself. Everyone, sit back down. Now, says this is my first session with you. That's because I have the last three royal therapists to the royal jelly. And from the looks of you, I think you'll be getting a bell pretty quickly.
I'm totally going to tell Ollie you did that.
If you do, I'll tell Dad that you totally took out the royal carriage without asking. Crashed it and blamed it on the Duke of Beef Wellington. Please stop! Now, since we've just met, I like to get to know everyone. Hopefully not get pressed in Royal Dragon or any other royal beast. So how about we go around and calmly introduce ourselves and say why we're unhappy.
I'm the Radiant Princess Civic, and I'm unhappy because there's nobody worthy of marrying me. I mean, yesterday, two suitors came to woo me, more of a boo than a woo. The first suitor owned only three castles, and two of them are on the west side of the kingdom. What a joke. I'm a princess. Do you really expect me to live in only three castles? I think not. I can name at least a dozen princesses who own more than four castles. They're half as beautiful as me.
Oh,
and the psychic suitor. I sent him packing when he gave me this measly little diamond. A princess has to have her standards. I'll just use this as a paperweight or maybe a doorstopper.
Thank you, Princess Cinnamon. How about you, Princess? You like to go next and follow your sister?
I have to gloss her hair. Well, just, you know, my name's Princess Peppermint. My sister, Princess Cinnamon, is always the first. And me, the beautiful, the smartest, and the bestest princess always has to go second. Cinnamon is such a show-off. With her hair and her eyelashes and the way she walks and stuff. She's always telling me I'm dumb, but it's not true. I'm just not smart. So there. I mean, having her for a sister is enough to ruin anyone's happiness. Like, what kind of name is Princess Cinnamon anyway?
It's better than Princess Peppermint, you goofy, bobbly candy cane.
Well, why don't you just say your Princess Cinnamon butt's there and be quiet?
Please stop! How about we let one of your brothers have a turn? How about you, Five Prince? Would you like to go next?
I don't introduce myself.
I present to you, Prince Harjo.
How many times do I have to tell you? It's pronounced Harjo. The bell is silent. Harjo. Please get it right.
Oh, I'm sorry, sir. I present to you Prince Harjay.
I am a dashing and spectacularly handsome Prince Harjay. My unhappiness is caused by all the jealousy I have to endure for just being such amazingly good looking.
Do we have to, ascend to this?
I mean, to be a prince and have a face and a physique that could have been chiseled by an angel? It's just too hard for someone to take. And I haven't even mentioned my hair. Wow.
Are you finished yet?
You just don't understand what it's like to be good looking. No, you really don't understand.
Why, you have time and it's arrogant and fool!
What language do you speak?
The dragon is getting hungry. How about we just take a deep breath and let your other brother have a turn?
Prince Slacker, wake up!
Wait, what time is it? Is it lunchtime yet? I'll just have a large royal pizza with everything on it. Oh, it's my turn. Being a prince is just way, way, way too much work.
Why are you so lazy? It's so embarrassing.
Well, at least he's not mean like you.
Who are you calling mean?
What's the hair? Especially the teeth.
Why?
It's an executive calling a prince cinnamon bun.
You already used that joke.
Well, it's funny.
No, it's not. How about we just take a time out and try to explore what we are feeling right now? Oh, you asked for it. Can everyone please stop? Please, ah!
I can't stop like this continued for hours. Kim was arguing.
That's my hairbrush.
No, it's
not. I had it first.
Well, I have it now.
There was whining.
Why? Why? Why am I in this family? Why?
And there was fighting.
I'm prettier.
I am! Eventually, the king and queen came to check on the royal therapist.
Excuse me, royal therapist. We've come to check on your progress.
Oh my, Barnabas, come quickly.
What have the children done?
No, they're worse than evil. They're. Oh, please don't feed me to the royal dragon. No, I'd rather be fed to the royal dragon than have in the same room your children ever again. Ah!
Dragon?
What is she talking about?
Princess Cinnamon.
So that's what happened to the other royal therapist.
What are we going to do?
I don't know, my dear. I don't know.
Over the next few months, the king and queen tried many things to make their children happy and hopefully bring some peace to the royal family. Their first idea was to marry off the children.
Children, your father and I have arranged for several worthy suitors to come and meet you. Each one has been handpicked and would make a wonderful spouse.
I hope this works.
Darling, we shall see.
Princess Cinnamon, I present to you the Duke of Cranberry.
Leave at once! Are you sure you don't want this gold?
There's the Prince of Salisbury steak.
Is it not rich enough?
What about Baron von Splitby? He's there too, he lives in the north.
Also, not rich enough. And I do think I can smell his breath from here.
Oh, look at this one. He's the Earl of the Snapper.
Definitely not rich enough. And rather strange looking. Is that hair on his head? Or did a wild beast climb up there and take a nap? Mother, none of these men are worthy of marrying me.
This is hopeless.
I noticed that you have flowers.
Oh, I almost forgot. I brought these flowers myself. Don't they really bring out the color of my eyes?
Of course they do.
Don't be a dear and have those brushes in the mirror over there. Excuse me. I need you to go over there. You're blocking my light.
I have never been so insulted in all my life.
Next.
Prince Slacker, I present to you the lovely...
Don't even bother. We're still the final elf and angry peasants of a royal smartphone.
One more try.
Princess Peppermint, I present to you the...
Greetings, beautiful princess. I do believe destiny has brought us together, for I am looking for a princess that will help me run the kingdom and be my true equal.
Equal to what?
Well, my equal. I mean, equality. You and me, my lovely buttercup. 1 + 1 = love.
I didn't know there's going to be any math on this date. If I had known there was going to be a math quiz step, then I would have, studied or something. So why don't you just go back to your genius kingdom with your fancy words and mathematical talents? Just go be inspiring kids by yourself.
But I was just...
No! Get out! Serves him right. The evil fairy.
That didn't go very well.
Darling, we can't give up.
Marrying off the children did not work. So the king and queen moved on to their next idea. Since it looked like they were stuck with their children forever, they decided to educate them. This rarely works.
Thank you.
Hey, where are the princes? Who are you? We are members of the dance crew.
I'm Bob and this is Jerry. I'm Bob and I know.
I'm in charge of costumes
and I know.
Jigsaw puzzle?
That's because you bought it for 7-year-olds.
Mother, there's nothing good to eat in the boil refrigerator.
We just had it filled yesterday.
As our magical time is coming to an end. very dangerous for a friend to enter a store, especially without pixie dust.
No problem. First, I have to write a few things down. Okay, I'll do it. But the narrator has to read this introduction for me. I wrote it myself.
Certainly, whatever needs to be done.
Then suddenly, imagine a merry, very energized man.
I mean, this man was like a cross between a professional football player and United States Marine.
Godmother.
Sky above,
Look at that great mirror.
Go away. Much better carrier.
Advice on how to find this fairy godmother?
Gaze upon the royal sofa. You will find the one with the knowledge to fill your mind.
Are you serious? The royal children's knowledge? You are a worse magic mirror than I thought.
To the Slacker's royal smartphone to bring the fairy godmother to your home.
Oh, very clever, mirror. Very clever. Give me that.
Hey!
I can't believe you always waste your time on this ridiculous game. What exactly is it anyway?
It's called Angry Peasants. See, you pull back the little slingshot like this and launch the angry peasants at these towers of the mean goats.
That's ridiculous. But oh, so addictive. Look, I hit a tower.
You did it, my dear.
Now, if I could just knock down that second tower, I'll get the rest of those pesky little goats. Wait, we should not be playing such a low-brow game. At least not on time backstage. Now, help me use this thing to contact the fairy godmother.
So Prince Slacker helped his parents contact the fairy godmother. And before they could say bippity-boppity-boo, she had arrived.
It's my turn!
It's my job!
Present to you, Miss Fairy Godmother.
I've been practicing.
Does someone need a little magic? Do you desire a wish, a spell, or a potion? If so, you need to look for another, because I am the one and only fairy godmother.
I'm so happy you could come. We want to make our families like the families in these fairy tales. Do you think you could do that?
Your Highness, fairy tales are what I do. I am the top fairy tale contractor in the business. But from the looks of your family, this is going to be a big job.
Ugh, I've heard enough of this. See ya, fairy lady.
Yeah, like we don't have to sit here and like listen to you compliment us. I am sure there are tons of people in this kingdom who would love to insult us. So I'm just gonna make like a banana and leave.
I have a few more notes there, so
actually, I would like to hang out here a little while longer. Get it? Mirror? Hang? Oh, I crack myself up sometimes. Ooh, there's another crack mirror. Oh, I deserve more time on stage and treat you too.
Where's everybody going?
Wait for me!
Like I was saying, this fairy tale is going to be a big job.
A big job?
How big a job?
Well, first, you're going to need to check with the Royal City Hall to see if this fairy is even so fairy tale. Then you'll need to get permits.
Permits?
Yes. You don't think you can just do a fairy tale without permits, too? And for a job this size, there are going to be a lot of materials. Okay, Royal Servant. Take this down. We are going to need 3 jars of butterfly sweat.
Excuse me, the pencil broke.
7 petals of a rainbow flower, 12 bags of stardust, a large carriage with a team of unicorns, a magic flute, 3 bottles of mermaid breath, 62 Fively clovers,
and the list went on and on,
3 crystals in Grim Valley, and 1 enchanted apricot.
I'm sorry, but my pencil broke after you said 3 jars of butterfly sweat. Could you please repeat that?
Give me that! Here is the grand proposal. This is what your happily ever after fairy tale.
Wow, that sure is a big number.
months?
To complete one fairy tale? What about the audience? I'm not sure they'll stay around much longer. Let alone 11 months.
You're trying to make the audience stay? I do magic, not miracles. Give me a coffee cake, do you mind? Tiddle it.
The king's dreams hope so shattered. Happiness has been within their grasp, but now it's just far away in the distant sunset. So the king did what all the press kings do.
I can't take it anymore. I'm going golfing.
And the queen did what all the press queens do. She grabbed it by the royal chips, sat on the royal sofa, and watched the royal 20-foot flat screen TV. It was during the third bag of royal chips that an advertisement came on that we were going to promote.
You had a chance at Depot. Happily Ever After was on every shelf, down every aisle.
We offer nothing but the best spells, potion, and magic for all of your fairy tale needs.
Need a frog to turn into a prince? We've got a potion for that.
Need to spin some straw into gold? Not a problem.
Our specially trained staff is ready to meet all your do-it-yourself fairy tale needs.
Just send your order on via enchanted airplane and we'll have your order ready to pick up.
We bring Happily Ever After to all your souls.
So we'll see you at Enchanted Depot.
Make your own fairy tale.
The queen grabbed a piece of purple parchment out of the drawer and started to devise a plan. She planned out every detail that would make her family from disaster to happily ever after. When she was finished, she summoned the page named Page.
Your Majesty, how may I serve you?
Not Penelope. What I have here is an extremely important list of items that I need from the Enchanted Depot. I need you to go at once and bring them back to the castle.
Yes, Your Majesty. One minor detail. My name is Paige. Remember, I'm the page named Paige.
I apologize, Patricia. Nun's journey is extremely important to the royal family.
I understand, but I'm Paige, Your Majesty.
I knew I could trust you, Penny. Now be off, and may the luck of the kingdom be with you.
Excuse me, ma'am. Don't I need the list?
No, Penny. I will be sending this list via enchanted paper airplane. That way, the order will be prepared and waiting for you when you arrive. I've had the servants fetch your fastest horse. It's time to send the list.
The queen held the enchanted airplane up high and carefully. When she felt the time was just right, she released the airplane. As it flew, it carried the hopes and dreams of the king and queen. It carried the idea of happily ever after, over mountains and through the woods, towards the royal castle.
Wow.
Enchanted depot.
We will now have a 10-minute intermission.
Thank you.
magic things. I'm working on a little fairy tale over by Jack's house. Thank you, another short. This means that we'll reach the clouds.
I personally guarantee it. Just make sure you watch out for mean, nasty giants if you choose to climb after planting.
Oh, I will.
This sure has been a busy day. I mean, there's been customers non-stop.
Speaking of customers, has the enchanted airplane orders come in yet?
Yeah, Rose up on the roof, making them now.
Loving Prince.
Excuse me. I'm not a princess, and I don't need to be rescued. But I do need my order filled.
Sorry, we didn't see you come in. Welcome to Enchanted Beaver.
How can we help?
I'm here to pick up an order for Queen Mildred. She sent it in the Enchanted Airplane.
It's right here. That's one sleeping potion, one Prince the Frog spell, one Rapunzel's hair special, and a love potion number 9.
Oh! It seems we're missing the genie now.
I'll go get one.
Oh, the lamp is right here.
Really?
Yes, and they're soft and dancing too. And if you like that,
I don't.
Oh. Look what I have a surface to do.
Consulted the fairy
No, there's more. According to the book, a prince will come along, scale a tower using her hair, and rescue Princess Peppermint. They will then get married, and we will once again live happily ever after.
You are amazing.
Now for the Prince Harjet. The main permit cocktail question is looking. It will turn into a frog, which then takes him in the pond out back. And the book says that a princess will come along, kiss him, and turn back into a prince. They will then get married, and you guessed it, we will live happily ever after.
He just keeps getting better and better. What's the plan for Prince Slacker?
Prince Slacker is the easiest one.
That's a portrait.
He simply needs to rub this magic lamp and a genie will appear. We just need to make sure that a princess will fall in love with Prince Slacker.
A genie is going to make a princess fall in love with Prince Slacker? That must be some powerful magic.
It is, and just in case I got this love potion, will make anyone fall in love with the first person he or she sees. So, your wonderful wife has thought of everything.
This does seem like a brilliant plan, but I think it's a little unnecessarily complicated.
That's how fairy tales work. Besides, what could possibly go wrong?
That was the plan. That was how it was supposed to happen. But we all know things rarely happen the way we plan them. This is true for you, for me, and especially for
Barnes,
so let me tell you what actually happened.
All right, it's time for our fandom to start. I know this will work.
I'm so excited to live happily ever after.
Now let's see, how did fairy tales start? Oh yes, with that famous grand lie. I'll hop and I'll pop and I'll blow your house down. No, that's not quite right. Oh yes, there's no place like home. There's no place like home. There's no. That's just not it. Oh yes, a long time ago, in a galaxy far, far away. No, that's not even close. Yes, once upon a time, there lived two princesses and two princes.
What do you want now?
We have some exciting news.
How long is this going to take?
We are going to create our own fairy tale.
Wait, do you want to do Little Red Riding Hood or something? I think not.
You must follow instructions very carefully. Let's see.
This is the stupidest idea yet. I mean, who wants to be in a fairy tale?
Oh, Princess Lily, please don't touch that.
Why not? I'll do whatever I want. Hey, this actually tastes pretty good.
You drank the wrong potion. You drank the love potion.
That means she'll fall in love with the first person she sees. Quick, cover her eyes.
Too late.
Hey, you. Come here.
Me?
Yes, you. What's your name?
Eddie.
The gallant and handsome Prince Eddie?
No, just Eddie. I'm not a prince. Actually, I'm a plumber.
And what brings you to this kingdom, Eddie the plumber?
I came to see this play. I had a catchy title, so I thought it might be good.
Did you travel here in your noble white steed?
No, I came in an old, broken-down blue Hyundai. I'm from Hoboken, New Jersey.
Mother, I love him. Come, Eddie, we're going to get married.
Married?
Yes, married!
Everything. Oh, powerful genie, please appear. Jeannie. I wish that we could all live a happily ever after.
No, no, no. No more wishes. No more castles or riches or making people fall in love. Why are people always asking me for things? They never ask me what I want. Do you know what? Do you?
A woman who doesn't want to do anything, is tired of helping people, and just wants to be left alone, I think I'm in love.
Why is my slacker chasing a genie?
Here, you're awake. We can still make this work. Prince Arjé. Princess Peppermint, come here. You get the gold potion, you get the green potion. Now let me check your mother's rose.
Yours is green. I like it better. And you got just a peppermint candy.
Well, you can't have it.
Look over there. Is that like a giant troll that's totally eating a royal hair dryer?
Whatever. You're so immature. I like this one better anyway. I like the way it glows all golden.
Okay, time to drink your potions and we'll have a happily ever after.
You mixed up the potions!
I feel strange. Ribbit!
Oh, well. Is my hair okay?
I don't care about your hair, I care about your sister.
Unlike her, I have a reputation to uphold. Is there something
I don't see? What is
she? I don't care. The princess is now a frog!
You're gonna turn me into a frog? Who's that supposed to help me? Frogs don't even have hair!
Well, speaking of hair, you drank your sister's potion. You should probably find a mirror in about 30 seconds.
Oh, I'm stuck here. I love the potion.
Now what are we going to do?
And my final point is...
I know. I'll call the Enchanted Depot customer service line.
Oh, come on, the king that Prince Slacker's rose got from, which had conveniently been left on the floor.
Greetings and welcome to the Enchanted Depot customer service line. Your call is important to us, so please listen to the following options. If you speak Old English, press 1. For a problem with a defective line room, press 2. If a dragon you purchase is used to keep peasants, press 3. For any questions regarding crystal balls or magic wands, press 4. If you are a king whose attempt at fairy tales gone terribly wrong, press 5.
Wow, that was strangely specific. I'll press 5.
So the king explained his problem to the customer service representative.
That does sound like a problem. So let me get this straight. One daughter is a frog. Another daughter is known as a plumber from Hoboken. Your wife drinks a sleeping potion. One son is chasing a crazy genie, and the other son, Jane Rapunzel, special?
Yep, that about sums it up. Please help.
I'll send out one of our top repair fairies. Her name is Flirta. She travels fast.
He waited, and as soon as the fairy arrived, I present to you Miss Glitterbell.
Dear Bell, thank you for coming. Do you think you can help? You do great. Princess Pepper, you ain't been prayer for a Glitterbell. Bad Froggy. Or bad Princess Froggy. Now what are we going to do?
Ha ha ha!
However, to answer your question, there is a flower that grows on a far, far, far away mountaintop that blooms once a year. However, it's guarded by a fire-breathing dragon. You'll need to send your greatest warriors on an epic journey to retrieve it.
Stop chasing me! I just want to be left alone and to be free!
Patrick Mirror, did you say you were looking for the greatest warrior to go on an epic journey?
Well, yes. Are you willing?
Don't look at me. I'm a lover, not a fighter. Oh, beautiful Jeannie, come back!
That does seem extremely difficult. Is there any other way?
Let me think. Oh, yes. You could also read the instructions like in the potions.
The instructions? section 27A, how to undo all spells. Let's see. It says, to repeat the line, powers of goodness, come to me and set my family free. Then it says to clap once and spin.
Why is it not working?
Oh dear, Jeannie. Turn the page. The spells continue on the other side.
Oh, this is rather involved.
Just follow the instructions.
It says to snap twice and do a pirouette. Then it says to hop three times on my biggest foot. Then it says to do a fish impression. Then it says to sing Rumpelstiltskin in an operatic voice. Rumpelstiltskin. Then it says to repeat the line, powers of goodness, come to me and set my family free.
As the king finished the last words, there were lightning bolts, a grand clump of smoke, and many other amazing effects that this production can't afford. But then, all of a sudden, all the spells were undone. Princess Peppermint was no longer frog, Prince Jay's hair went back to normal, and the queen woke up.
Wait. I'm stopping the story right here.
What are you doing?
There's no need for fairy intervention. I stopped the story because the nice king and queen are still stuck with their obnoxious bratty children, just like they were all along. Nothing has been accomplished.
Oh, my fairy friend, you are missing the point.
What point?
The spells may be broken, but the experience they had may change them.
And sometimes experience is more powerful than magic.
Watch, my friend, as we let this story continue, we love your enchanted fairy dance and get the ball moving too.
I do know what happened, but I'm still not doing this foolish fairy dance.
Where is Glitterbell?
have the proper authority to investigate all fairies.
Who are you?
I'm the fairy tale inspector. King Barnabas and Queen Mildred, you face some very serious charges. There are allegations of conducting a fairy tale without a permit, illegal spells, and attempting to turn a person into a toad.
Actually, it was a frog, and we think she's back to normal now.
Ma'am, you still need a fairy tale permit for that kind of thing. There's also a rumor that an unauthorized release of a genie has occurred. In addition, there are numerous violations that include fairy abuse, subjecting an audience to bad puns, and the blatant use of forced rhymes. And that's just my first page.
None of this is answering the question of where Glitterbell is.
I bet they have her locked up.
We should look around and find her.
Look, the big bug is back.
I'm not a bug. I'm a fairy, and I'm stopping to get few of these royal cookies.
Are you a little large, deep fairy?
No, I'm just a big bone fairy.
Maybe he is Glitterbell.
No, my daughter the frog ain't Glitterbell.
Stop eating those cookies.
Get back to me with those royal cookies. Come here. I need some answers, and I need them now.
Everyone started to argue and fight.
It was a terrible scene. It was pure royal chaos. That isn't how we page noticed something.
Hey guys, wait a minute. Look, they look happy.
When you finish attaching the pipe, turn on the gas, and voila, you have new high efficiency tankless water heater.
I just love it when you talk plumbing. Tell me that shower fixture story again.
And look over there. They look happy, too.
I was just so passionate about my cabinet lamp. It was like all the walls are closing in on me. I just couldn't wait to get out and experience the world around myself.
You totally complete me.
What is this?
If I'm not mistaken, it looks like they're in love. And it looks like they're in love, too.
Prince Slacker and Princess Cinnamon, come here now. Please explain to me what's going on.
Mom, Dad, I have some big news.
I have some big news, too.
You first.
No, sister, you may go first.
No, brother, please, go first.
Sister, it is common courtesy that I let you go first.
I yield this honor to you.
This is almost as annoying as when they were fighting. Princess Cinnamon, you start.
Okay, if you insist. My news is that me and Eddie are getting married. I'm going to be a former's wife.
That's my news, too.
You're also going to be a former's wife?
No, Jeannie and I are going to get married.
Oh, what wonderful news! We shall have a double wedding!
Are you sure the spell wore off?
I think so.
Yes, this is the real thing. Once I saw the kindness in Eddie's heart, and he gave me the ride in his blue Hyundai, I just had to make my mind!
Plus, you should hear him talk about plumbing. It's fascinating.
For me, Jeannie and I just connected. Jeannie is tired of working for others and granting everyone else's wishes. She just wants to hang out and be free. That's exactly what I've been looking for in a girl.
You're so sweet to understand me.
Let's start planning this grand wedding.
Wait! You all forgot about me, the fairy tale inspector, and all the
Oh, that's wonderful.
Yes, the only problem is, ever since I've been a frog, I've had this terrible stomach ache.
Oh, quick, someone call a doctor. My burly daughter is sick.
Oh, I really don't feel good.
Oh, I never noticed the narrator.
Oh, rude of us. Narrator, would you like some tea?
No, thank you. So the queen continued to raise page and page.
You have the kind of keen listening skills and work ethic to be a great leader. I promoted you to head of the royal army. You are no longer a page named Page. You are now a knight named Page.
She finally got my name right.
My jigsaw puzzle. Well, if you adjust for the tutu, it's a cat hanging on a rope and it says, hang in there, baby. That's a good one. Yeah, so funny.
Well, then you believe I finished my bonsai tree.
Oh, the joys of a quiet castle.
Just a wise king.
And a brilliant queen.
Ruling in peace and quiet.
Surprisingly, the king and queen also enjoyed their children and relished in their accomplishments. Princess Peppermint graduated with honors from Royal University.
definitely the best looking.
More importantly, he only occasionally graced the castle with his presence, and of course there's a royal level wedding.
Be on the lookout